Hello everyone, this is Edionic. In this third and final part of op-amp circuit tutorial, we will be learning the four other important op-amp circuits. They are the instrumentation amplifier, the buffer amplifier also known as voltage follower, the comparator also known as the voltage level detector, and the, finally the Schmitt trigger called as the regenerating comparator often. So let's move on to our first type. Instrumentation amplifier are used, as the name suggests, in instrumentation. That is, there are transducers used in instrumentation and applications. So these transducers sometimes fail to provide sufficient power to drive the next stage of the processing. So we use this instrumentation amplifier to supply the sufficient power to drive the processes. An instrumentation amplifier should have the following basic categories in the list. So characteristics are low power consumption, high input impedance, low output impedance, and high CMRR. Other low thermal drift, etc. are also there, but these are the four important ones. So let's draw the circuit of an instrumentation amplifier. So the circuit of an instrumentation amplifier consists of two non-inverting amplifiers in the input stage and one difference amplifier in the output stage. So the input stage would appear like this, with two non-inverting op-amps in the input stage. That is, the first one, A1 and A2, are the two non-inverting amplifiers. Now let's draw the output stage. In the output stage is a difference amplifier that we already studied in the last module. Now for analyzing the circuit, I redrew this input side, and I'm going to apply the virtual short and zero current principles. Applying virtual short, I can see that this point and this point will have the same voltage, that is V in 1. So this point is same as this point right here. So V in 1 is a voltage at this point, let it be A. At this point B, similarly, we will get a voltage V in 2. So the current through RG is given by I equals V in 1 minus V in 2 divided by RG. This is our current through this resistor. Now you can see that this voltage is V out 1 and this is V out 2, and the current drawn by the both the terminals is 0. So this current and this current is absolutely 0. So the current passing through this branch, whole branch, is same as the current passing through the RG resistor, which we already found out. So the current passing through the whole branch is I equal to potential difference, that is V out 1 minus V out 2, divided by the total resistance, that is the sum of all three resistances. Now on equating these, we would get RG equals V out 1 minus V out 2 divided by RF 1 plus RG plus RF 2. So assuming that RF 1 and RF 2 are equal resistances, equal to some RF, and simplifying, we would get something like this, that V out 2 minus V out 1, that is difference between the two voltages, is equal to 2 RF plus RG divided by RG into V in 2 minus V in 1. So this is our equation 1. Now for this difference amplifier right here, we have the two inputs V out 1 and V out 2, and the gain is from our difference amplifier, okay, that is, our gain is R2 by R1. That is the feedback by the input resistor. As this is given to the negative terminal, we get a negative sign in the gain. So we can write the equation for this output stage as V out equals minus R2 by R1 into V out 1 minus V out 2, which are the two inputs of this amplifier. So with a negative sign. Okay, now substituting this equation and equation number 2, we get the output voltage V out as R2 by R1 times 1 plus 2 RF by RG on simplifying this term into V into minus V in 1. So this is the output we get from our instrumentation amplifier. Second circuit is voltage follower or buffer amplifier. So in this amplifier, it is almost similar to the non-inverting amplifier shown right here. In this non-inverting amplifier, we have already learned that the gain is 1 plus RF by RI. So if we take RF as equal to 0 and RI equal to infinity, we can cancel out this term and gain is equal to 1, which means the output voltage would be the same as the input voltage, that too without any variation in the phase. That is our voltage follower. So we can redraw it as minus plus, and we are giving the voltage input voltage at positive terminal or non-inverting terminal, and on shorting RF and open circuiting R1, we get a circuit like this. This is our voltage follower circuit, where VO is equal to 1, that is gain, into VI. That is, output voltage is directly equal to the input voltage. The circuit we are discussing is a comparator or voltage level detector. A comparator is defined as a circuit which compares a signal voltage applied to one input of an op amp with a known reference voltage at the other input, and produces either a high or a low output voltage depending on which is higher. So a comparator would generally have like two states in its output, either a V plus VSAT or a minus VSAT, and if the input voltage is greater than the reference voltage, it would produce a high or V plus VSAT. If the input voltage is less than our reference voltage, it would produce minus VSAT. So we can compare a voltage with respect to a reference voltage. So here I am considering a non-inverting comparator. So in the non-inverting terminal, we give the input, that is input VI, and in the inverting terminal, we give a reference voltage, or V reference here. So this voltage is compared with respect to V reference here. So as you can see, this is an open loop op amp circuit. So for a small signal, it would produce a high gain and high output. Ideally, it would go to infinity, but as we have mentioned earlier, it goes to saturation. So that is why we get values like VSAT and minus VSAT and no waveform. So if the VI or input voltage is a time varying signal like this, and we can see that this voltage would go less or higher or lower than this V reference. So if it goes higher than V reference, the positive terminal or the non-inverting terminal dominates, so we get a positive VSAT as the output. So if VI greater than V reference, VSAT is the output, and if VI is less than V reference, we get minus VSAT at the output. So if this is our input signal and this voltage level is our reference voltage, when the voltage is less than the V reference, we would get a minus VSAT, and the instant it goes above V reference, you would get a positive VSAT. So the waveform would be like this, where the maximum value plus VSAT and minimum value minus VSAT. So if this V reference is a negative value, we would get a V reference here, and similar way we can write the output. So in some cases the comparator is also used as a zero level crossing detector, in which V reference is zero, so we get a for all positive voltages we get plus V saturation, and for all negative voltages we get minus V saturation. Zero level detector. So now let's move on to our last, the Schmitt trigger. In comparator circuits, we have observed that we did not give a feedback. So a very little noise in the input can possibly be amplified and can produce a distorted output. So Schmitt trigger is a modified version of comparator, and it's also known as regenerative comparator because in this circuit we give a positive feedback. As positive feedback is also known as regenerative feedback, the Schmitt trigger is also called regenerative comparator. So here I am considering a inverting op-amp Schmitt trigger. Here, as you might have observed, instead of giving a V reference or reference voltage, we are giving positive feedback. So in this case, or in Schmitt trigger, the voltage goes to a high value when the input voltage exceeds a certain threshold value. So unlike in comparator where it is V reference, here it is V threshold. So like in the comparator, first we get a V saturation here because positive feedback has not yet acted. So when positive V sat comes here, there would be a voltage coming as feedback. So this voltage V2, we can find out as this portion can be redrawn as R1, R2, and this is Vsat, and we require V2, which is a voltage across R2. That means V2 equals, applying voltage divide rule, R2 into Vsat by R1 plus R2. So this is actually our V upper threshold, VUTH. Similarly, with corresponding to minus Vsat, we can calculate V lower threshold as minus Vsat R2 by R1 plus R2. So we got the two threshold voltages. So let's consider a time varying signal like this, and the upper threshold and lower threshold voltages we know. I'm marking here VUTH and VLTH. So as this is inverting, when the value of input goes above the upper threshold, the negative terminal dominates and we get a negative output, and when it goes below our lower threshold, we would get a high value. So because it is inverting, the sense is directly opposite. So here I'm just marking like this so that we can draw easily. So before it crosses this point, or before exceeding VTH, the input is lesser than V upper threshold, so we get a high value. And at that instant, when it crosses upper threshold, it becomes greater than upper threshold, and because it is connected to the inverting terminal, we get a low value. So then the minus Vsat comes at the output, and now we have to consider the lower threshold voltage at V2. So now when the input crosses the lower threshold right here, or when it becomes lower, we get a high value as it is inverting. So this is our Schmitt trigger output waveform. So we have discussed all the main circuits with op-amps There are also circuits for wave generation, the square wave, triangular wave, sawtooth generation waveforms, which I'll be doing a video soon. So please subscribe and like this video. Thank you.